just a week before that referendum back in 2016, I was in the Bullring Market in Birmingham, and we went round meeting all the traders, meeting the shoppers, and I remember getting back on the bus, leaving, thinking, wow, that went really, really well. And it matters because we are here in the heart of England. And how the heart of England votes is how the rest of the country will vote. And to the astonishment of our political leaders in Westminster, to the horror of much of the media commentariat, and I do include Andrew Marr and the BBC in that, yes, oh yes, absolutely. And I think many others were very surprised on the 23rd of June 2016. I suspect President Obama was quite surprised as well. David Cameron, of course, resigned the next day. And of course, we'd been told by George Osborne that 500,000 jobs would go, taxes were going to go up, interest rates would go up, house prices would collapse, foreign and direct investment would leave the country, plagues of black locusts would descend upon our land. And to the horror of all of them, and in particular, the one person who I think was most appalled when we heard that Birmingham and the West Midlands had voted to leave on that evening. I think the person who was most horrified by the result that we decided to leave was one Anna Soubry. So it was a great day, it was a great day, and the West Midlands in many ways did lead the way with some really big, big leave votes in some of these constituencies. And, you know, the next year we had a general election. We were told Brexit means Brexit. But we were also told by the Labour Party that they would respect the result of the referendum. And don't forget that 500 members of Parliament had voted for Article 50, which became part of the law in this country. That's important. And what did it say? What did it say? It said, we will leave the European Union on March 21. At 11 p.m. and we'll leave with or without a withdrawal agreement. And I really thought we'd won. I really thought it was going to happen, because I thought we lived in a civilized, democratic nation that respected the rule of law. I had underestimated the sheer levels of dishonesty amongst our political class. They have done everything to prevent the greatest democratic exercise in the history of our nation from taking place, and I think the whole thing is an absolute disgrace. I had to think, what am I going to do? Am I going to stand aside? Am I going to stand aside and be rolled over by these people to allow 25 years of work of my adult life to turn into dust because of the sheer dishonesty and duplicity of our political class? Or am I going to stand up and fight? And I chose to stand up and fight. And that is why I formed the Brexit Party. And I am absolutely thrilled that we have got men and women of the caliber integrity and courage who are standing with me in this election, such as those on this platform this evening with me. Here's the important thing. There's no point in just getting mad. There's no point in just fulminating with rage against the treachery and duplicity of all of our political leaders. What we now have to do is look calmly and I think optimistically at what is before us. Here in the West Midlands, you have seen the choice. You've seen the Brexit Party menu. What does it look like if you were considering going out and voting for Mrs. May's Conservative Party? Well, let me tell you, the two leading Conservative candidates in the West Midlands are both Remainers. And the two leading Labour candidates in the West Midlands are Remainers, who both support a second referendum, because you didn't know what you were voting for, did you? Did you know what you were voting for? To think that Mrs. May is going to bring back to the House of Commons for a fourth time. I mean, talk about the definition of insanity. Doing the same thing again and again and expecting a different result. And by the way, it is not Mrs. May's deal. It is a new European treaty written by Monsieur Barnier with Angela Merkel looking over his shoulder. Well, at least Angela Merkel's elected. Barnier's not elected. Tusk's not elected. And Jean-Claude Juncker, after lunch, has got no idea whether he was ever elected to anything. Yeah, it's okay. I'm going through my low booze hypocritical stage at the moment. But the point is, we are being deceived. We're being told to leave one set of European treaties, to sign up to another European treaty, which in many ways is as bad, if not worse, than the current arrangement. And we will be damned if we're going to accept it. And just to really put me in the mood, they've been negotiating with Mr. Corbyn's Labour Party, discussing the possibility of tying us in to the customs union on a permanent basis and alignment with single European market rules. They've actually been attempting a coalition of the politicians against the people. Well, let me tell you, we're the people, the Brexit Party are the people, and they are in for the shock of their lives come next Thursday. So let us be positive. Let us be upbeat. Let us say that we believe in our country. We believe in its people. We believe in our ability to make our own laws. We believe in our own ability to chart our own destiny. We believe that we should be able to choose our own friends around the world and form whatever relationship we choose from them. And we think starting with the Commonwealth would be a very good idea. Well, what a surprising reaction. I thought you were all narrow-minded little Englanders. You see, they don't get it, do they? They don't understand. We want to be free. We want to be proud of who we are as a country. And we want to live in a system of democracy, something that the generations that went before us sacrificed so much in two world wars to make sure that we could enjoy. I truly believe, as a nation, we are now lions led by donkeys, and it's time we did something about it. And we will. This is about more. This is about far more now than just leaving the European Union. This is about the very democratic system in our country. It's about the bond of trust that needs to exist between the governors and the governed for our civilization to carry on with the underpinning that it has. You see, democracy only works if the losers accept the result. But our political class haven't accepted the result. And so our job now is far bigger, far more ambitious than just campaigning for Brexit. Our job now is to completely transform the political landscape in this country, to sweep aside a two-party system that now serves only itself.